Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel, and this week I thought I would show you guys my maintenance routine to make sure I don't look like a complete and utter piece of beep. It's all about the eyebrows, the hair dye, the fake tan, doing my nails, and all beauty maintenance sort of things. But I didn't really explain that, so I hope you guys enjoy. Don't forget to subscribe. Let's just get on with the video.
I've decided I'm bringing you guys along for my maintenance routine so I don't look like this. Fake tan, much necessary. Hair dye, much necessary. Eyebrows need doing for sure. I need to just maintain my life, but physically is our main priority, okay? So let's go do it. Oh my God, I need my tripod, else you guys ain't gonna be able to see anything. Not too bad. Not my most flattering lighting, I have to say. Shampoo and conditioner, this is the Kitsch. I still use the rice water and castor oil. It's the only thing that honestly grows my hair so quickly. As someone who likes to switch up their hair, it's honestly a blessing. For body, I'm gonna scrub with this Fenty Cherry Scrub and then the Cherry Face Wash. I don't shave, I shave tomorrow after I fake tan tonight. For some reason, whenever I fake tan and shave at the same time, I get all the dots on my legs, so I do it the day after. Even though it does remove a bit of your tan, honestly, I'd rather that than the black dots. Before we go in the shower, I do need to put my glaze on. I use this to like maintain a hair dye or to like pass over time when I need to dye my hair. It kind of just refreshes. It's like a semi-permanent dye and I just plop this on. Let's switch out of this. I'm gonna do this. Yikes. I say linear hairbrush, but honestly, I think this will do. This is not a hairbrush, this is a head massager. Then what I'm gonna do, put some towel down so I don't get on the side, put these on, and rock and roll. I've been using it for years, especially when I have dark hair, because I hate the second my hair gets a little bit warm. Any other black haired girl will know, and this stuff's always stopped it. Even now when my hair's like got rootage, I just like to put this on to blend hair dye that's already in my hair through to the not so dyed roots at the moment. Normally either do a conditioning gloss like this or I will actually dye my hair. It stains enough, by the way, guys, that if you do get it places, you want to get it off. So let me attack this. You see, make sure these front bits have really got the coating, because that's what kind of what matters to me the most. Honestly, I'm not too precise with this. If this was hair dye, I'd be much more anal is the right word probably about this. I'm just making sure that my hair is not dry and gross like it just was. You saw it. I make it all shiny and same-ish color. I tend to get like 3 uses out per bottle, so it's also nice because I don't have to keep buying a hair dye. This is what it looks like. It's so quick to dye a bob. Clip the hair. I'm gonna come back and see you guys once this is all marinated. Can't actually remember how long I'm supposed to keep this on for. So the hair dye's now been on for honestly I think 25 minutes. I can't remember. I was watching the Balancing Friends and Boyfriends with Hot Mess. That's been on. I'm gonna go use all the products I showed you earlier in the shower, clean up. So I'll see you guys in a second. Oh Lord have mercy. I am out the shower. I did unfortunately dye the bottom of the shower pink. Not sure how, not sure why, but that's the situation we're in. I'm gonna go sort that out and then we can get started with the situation. Already, I feel a million trillion times better, which is stunning. I also managed to get the pink out the bath. Slash shower basin. See, I mean, don't mind the paint coming off, but it's white. It's brow time. I use for my brows Just for Men color base. I saw this on this girl called Lysia on TikTok, and she said that it lasts longer, it's more ashy toned, and I believed everything she said, and thank God I did, because she was completely right. If you dye your eyebrows on a regular basis, just get beard dye. Such a better investment. Just gonna mix these together. This is the developer. I just oh no. Okay, I'm just gonna mix this together with the spoolie. Don't mind my nails, that's also part of our routine tonight, like so. And then I just run this through the hairs on my eyebrows. I don't like do the whole mapping them out how I feel in my brows, because honestly I do
not fill my brows in the exact same way every single day. I just prefer to make sure that all the hairs running through my brows are dark, and then whatever shape comes out of it comes out of it. Do you know what I mean? You can always go back and do another layer is what I always think, but the thought of having two darker brows, since I have to be on camera most days, shock of my life. This part I can't medically recommend to you, but I do enjoy shoving a little bit just on the ends of my lashes. I try not to go too close to my actual eyeball because this isn't safe for eyes, I don't believe, but the ends of my lashes tend to be just slightly lighter than the base of my lashes, so having a little, so putting a little bit of brow dye on does wonders. So whatever's left of my spoolie, I'll just run back through. And I also, if I haven't dyed my hair, oh by the way, I didn't wash my hair in the shower because I was like, oh yeah, you've just dyed it, so I just ended up putting conditioner on. Sometimes I'll put it in my baby hairs or something like that, just so that the front of my face all looks coherent in color. But yeah, I'm gonna just go sit, let this process. Honestly, I leave the front, I'll come back anyway, but I generally leave the front parts on for like 5 to 10 minutes and then the rest of them on 15. I'm just wiping off the front of my brows, and as you can see, that's a spot, don't mind that. But I think I'm just gonna take off the whole brow. That looks pretty good if you ask me. I don't want them to be too crazy. I'm also gonna take off my lashes. What I'm gonna do is I'm growing this slit back out. However, this one I want to keep. I'm gonna chop her back in. And did I do that way too wide? Probably. I'm gonna clean up around the edges of my brows too with this. It definitely does a lot for the lashes, I would say. Like, small change but a big difference. Okay, first of all, not the hair dye on my hand. I just rubbed the hair dye. Look how bad that is. No, it looks like shit. Look at that. I'm gonna remove the remainder of the remainder of the nail varnish and any hair dye I can remove from my nails, and then I'm gonna paint them one of these reds, whichever one isn't running out, because I then am gonna paint it on my toes too. But I'm gonna do this while I am watching. Now this is Living Madeline Argy episode. I would let you guys watch, but I don't know how to put you on a time lapse, and I'm not switching to the phone because the quality is different. Gonna do a before and after instead. My nails look so gross. That's kind of the reason I'm doing red, because something's got to be dark to cover the that. Do you know what I mean? If I do this now, should I fake tan first? But my hair's not even close to dry. I should really fake tan first, huh? Okay, let's go do that first, and then we'll come back to this. Why does my tripod look like nervous? Its legs are all doing up in madness. Bit of an awkward angle, but it works. For tans, honestly, I use a wide range depending on the motion I'm going with. So if I'm desperate for a tan, I use the Rose and Caramel Ultra Dark. Same for the Bali Bobby, but I'm like running out of this one. But if I just want like a nice tan that I'm going to be able to maintain through the week, if I need to put another layer on, I can. That sort of vibe, then I'll go with one of the Saint Tropez or Bondi Sands. I think I'm gonna go with this one. I don't necessarily need anything too crazy. Now, it would be really cheeky to let you guys see me apply this, but this is the before. It looks the same on camera, but I promise I look more tanned in real life. Plus, these ones both don't have a color guide. I ended up mixing both the Saint Tropez and the Bondi Sands together, just because it was easier to apply that way. But I like both of these because the color guard isn't crazy, so it just makes for a nice looking tan. But now we can go do our nails. Okay, we're back, we're now tanned. Now we can do our nails. The hair dye is really doing up a nut for me, but I think I'm gonna go with a little bit of a sparkly red, because why not? And I'm just gonna do my hands and nails while I watch this podcast. I'm glad I just faked hands, because I really couldn't be bothered to do that. So I'm glad that's done now.
You like blew up on social media.
I feel like a badina right now. Tanned, nails done. I mean, I did bite, you know, when you like pull one string back and that. I've got to wash my hands to like get rid of the rest of the nail varnish, but gotta love it. I feel so much better. I'm just gonna wait for these and my toes to dry. And we can finish up the maintenance. Good morning. Thought I'd come do a quick little check-in. This is the update on the tan. I still haven't washed it off. It is the night after our reset. A few things I didn't do. Clean my room. But we did do all the physical things we needed to do. But I hope you guys have enjoyed maintaining my maintenance with me.
I'm gonna go in the shower, get ready, and then I will do my last check-in with you. And I've really enjoyed doing my maintenance routine with you guys, and I hope you have too.
Still need to clean my room, but I have showered off the tan. This is what the mixture of the tans look like. Do you guys, I mean, don't mind this part, I clearly missed it. I've been loving talking to you guys in the comments of my Leah Holton video. I feel really happy responding to your comments, seeing your feedback. I'm gonna go drink my coffee, catch up on some admin, and I'll speak to you in a bit.
That is the end of my maintenance routine. I hope you guys enjoyed. I hope you found it somewhat interesting or helpful, whether it's the product or what, or you just enjoyed being here for the vibes. This is the finished maintained look. This is the makeup look I'm actually uploading next week. I have been doing the Tyler makeup look so much recently, so if you're interested in this makeup, make sure to subscribe and turn on notifications, because that will be up next week. I hope you guys enjoyed, and I will catch you guys very, very soon. Deuces.